2004, τρία χρόνια μετά, βρισκόμαστε στο Παγκόσμιο Κέντρο Εμπορίου, στο μέρος όπου πριν από τρία χρόνια έγινε η μεγαλύτερη επίθεση στην ιστορία των Ηνωμένων. Όμως, σύμφωνα με μια τελευταία δημοσκόπηση, το 50% των Νεοϋορκέζων πιστεύουν ότι η Αμερικανική κυβέρνηση ήξερε από πριν ότι θα γίνει τρομοκρατική επίθεση, αλλά δεν έκανε τίποτα για να την αποτρέψει. Βρεθήκαμε ξανά στη Νέα Υόρκη για να μάθουμε πώς και γιατί οι μισοί από τους κατοίκους της πόλης πιστεύουν κάτι τέτοιο.
Rice, would you please rise and raise your right hand? Do you swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
You swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Στα τέλη του 2002, μετά από ισχυρές πιέσεις και με μεγάλη καθυστέρηση, ο Λευκός Οίκος δέχθηκε να δημιουργηθεί μια επιτροπή για να εξετάσει τι πραγματικά συνέβη στις 11 Σεπτεμβρίου του 2001. Καθοριστικό ρόλο έπαιξαν οι δημόσιες εκκλήσεις από τους συγγενείς των θυμάτων.
Initially my rage was directed at the hijackers. Why did they do this? What did they expect to accomplish? What had Lisa done to them? I also became angry at my government. The government that was supposed to protect Lisa.
I am angry. Two of the hijackers that were on my wife's plane, Khalid al-Midhar and Nawaf al-Hazmi, were, we knew for a long time that the CIA knew about them and didn't put them on the watch list and didn't inform the FBI about them so that they couldn't be caught when they were in this country. Now we find out that they were apparently key plotters of the 9/11 attacks. And had they been captured earlier on, or had they been followed and investigated more thoroughly, it's possible that they might have been able to prevent the attacks.
Τελικά ο πρόεδρος Bush δέχθηκε να σχηματιστεί μια επιτροπή, αλλά διόρισε για πρόεδρό της τον Henry Kissinger. Για τους αντιπάλους του ήταν η καλύτερη απόδειξη ότι ήθελε να κρύψει την αλήθεια.
The Bush administration fought the formation of this commission for 18 months. Until it finally got the one concession it wanted, which was to be able to pick the chairman, and they picked Henry Kissinger. If you want to keep a secret, you appoint Henry Kissinger. He's perfect for the job. He knows where more bodies are buried than all the mortuary guys in America combined.
Ο Kissinger παραιτήθηκε γρήγορα από πρόεδρος. Δήλωσε ότι τα συμφέροντα που εκπροσωπεί η εταιρεία του έρχονταν σε σύγκρουση με το έργο της επιτροπής.
And the irony there is that he had to quit, he had to step down because his business interests would conflict with his ability to investigate this terrorist act. I've always wondered what kind of business interests does Henry Kissinger have that would create a conflict of interest with the most astounding terrorist attack in history. It just, you know, excuse me, that doesn't make a lot of sense.
Η συνέχεια δεν ήταν πολύ καλύτερη. Ο Γενικός Διευθυντής της Επιτροπής, Φιλίπ Ζέλικοφ, είναι στενός συνεργάτης της Προεδρικής Συμβούλου του Κοντολίζα Ράις. Είχαν συγγράψει ένα βιβλίο. Ο Μαξ Κλίλαντ, το πιο μαχητικό μέλος της Επιτροπής, διορίστηκε από τον Μπους πρόεδρος μιας δημόσιας επιχείρησης και αποχώρησε. Η αντικαταστάτης του είναι συνεργάτης της CIA. Οι δημόσιοι υπάλληλοι που κλήθηκαν να καταθέσουν συνοδεύονταν από πράκτορες της κυβέρνησης. Σε μέλη της Επιτροπής, ακόμα και σε πρώην βουλευτές όπως ο Τιμ Ρέμερ, απαγορεύτηκε να έχουν πρόσβαση σε σημαντικά έγγραφα.
I started yelling and screaming and objecting and kicking at some doors and talking to people in the press, and quickly that decision was reversed. But that's actually a good anecdote for what we're up against in a daily struggle.
Τον Μάιο του 2004 η Επιτροπή εξέδωσε την ετοιμιγορία της. Προϊόν συμβιβασμών, το πόρισμα παρουσιάζει τις ελλείψεις των υπηρεσιών ασφαλείας, αλλά δεν καταλογίζει ευθύνες σε κανένα. Για τον πρώην πράκτορα της CIA, Mel Goodman, πρόκειται για συγκάλυψη.
It is 3 years after 9/11, and we still know nothing about who was accountable, what mistakes were made. But if we don't understand the mistakes that were made, and we don't understand what the motivation and the role of the people who made these mistakes were all about, I don't see how you can ever correct the mistake.
Tonight exclusive, the President of the United States, George W. Bush, and his wife, Laura Bush, for the hour together. George W. Bush, Laura Bush, next on Larry King Live.
You first were opposed to the 9/11 commission and then changed. Why?
Not really.
You weren't opposed.
Well, I just wanted to make sure that it was done the right way. I felt like that one of my concerns was is that it would usurp the Congress's need to fully investigate. Then I recognized this was a good avenue and a good venue and a good way to really get out the facts, and they did a really good job.
Δεν έχουν όλοι την ίδια γνώμη. Πριν από ένα μήνα, την τρίτη επέτειο της 11ης του Σεπτέμβρη, νυν και πρώην πράκτορες της CIA, του FBI και άλλων υπηρεσιών ασφαλείας έδωσαν κοινή συνέντευξη τύπου στην Ουάσιγκτον. Σε μια επιστολή τους προς το Αμερικανικό Κογκρέσο, ζητούν να ανοίξει ξανά ο φάκελος της τρομοκρατικής επίθεσης.
We the undersigned who have worked within various government agencies, FBI, CIA, FAA, DIA, Customs, responsible for national security and public safety, call upon you in Congress to include the voices of those with first-hand knowledge and expertise in the important issues at hand. We stand ready to do our part. Respectfully, Edward J. Costello Jr., former Special Agent, Counterintelligence, FBI, John M. Cole, FBI, Lean A. Larkin, former Operation Officer, CIA, Raymond L. McGovern, former Analyst, CIA.
Σύμφωνα με τους ειδικούς, το τελικό πόρισμα είναι ένας πάκος άχρηστα χαρτιά για ανακύκλωση.
The people who wrote this book tell us that the murders of 3,000 Americans on 9/11/2001 could not have been prevented. I would ask any of those of you who believe this to raise your hand, please.
Για να μάθει πώς και γιατί πέθανε η σύζυγός του, ο Στέβεν Πους αποφάσισε να κάνει τη δική του έρευνα. Προσέλαβε έναν detective και παράτησε τη δουλειά του.
In December of 2001, I retired from my career in public relations to do it full time to working on finding accountability for 9/11.
And how long are you going to do it?
Unfortunately, I think that may be for a very long time. There are probably hundreds, if not thousands, of unanswered questions about 9/11.
Τις ημέρες πριν την 11η του Σεπτέμβρη, στο χρηματιστήριο του Σικάγου παίχθηκε ένα πολύ περίεργο παιχνίδι με τις συμμετοχές της American και της United Airlines, το δύο αεροπορικών εταιριών που έχασαν αεροπλάνα στις 4 αεροπειρατείες. Κάποιοι είχαν στοιχηματίσει $1,000,000 ότι οι μετοχές των δύο εταιριών θα έπεφταν και μετά κέρδισαν πολλά χρήματα. Το γεγονός αυτό παρακίνησε τον δημοσιογράφο Kyle Hens να ξεκινήσει μια επιτροπή πολιτών για την 11η του Σεπτέμβρη.
My doubts about the official story were born when I read stories and saw on news coverage reports of insider trading. In the airline business, the principal carriers in the US are Delta, United, and American. In this case, the pattern, the spikes were with United and American, but not Delta. There were sophisticated investors that bet that United and American stocks would fall.
Ταξιδέψαμε στο Λος Άντζελες για να βρούμε τον άνθρωπο που έχει μελετήσει την κερδοσκοπία με τις μετοχές. Ο Μάικ Ρούπερτ είναι παλιός αστυνομικός και σήμερα εκδότης ενός ενημερωτικού δελτίου με αποκλειστικές πληροφορίες.
Insider trading is one of the biggest anomalies of 9/11. Here at home in America, we had CBS News, we had Bloomberg, a major financial service. All kinds of major outlets acknowledged that the trading was horrendous. We saw levels of trading in some cases 1,200% above normal in put options. And again, just very briefly, a put option is a bet that a stock price is going to fall.
Οι συγγενείς των θυμάτων ήταν οι μόνοι που έθεσαν ερωτήματα για αυτή την ανομαλία.
Never before on the Chicago Exchange were such large amounts of United and American Airlines options traded. These investors netted a profit of several million dollars after the September 11th attacks. Interestingly, the names of the investors remain undisclosed and the millions remain unclaimed in the Chicago Exchange account.
What was very interesting about some of the trades on United Airlines, is that most of them were placed through a subsidiary of Deutsche Bank called Alex Brown, the Alex Brown unit of Deutsche Bank, which had been headed until 1998 by a man by the name of A.B. Buzzy Krongard. And Krongard was on 9/11 the executive director. That's the number three position at the Central Intelligence Agency.
The documentary evidence is that those orders were placed, that there was that it was unprecedented in scope and scale. They identified, I think, 38 companies that there was some anomalous activity, and yet we have no answers from the SEC or the DOJ, the Department of Justice.
Στην αρχή, οι επιθέσεις στις 11 του Σεπτέμβρη παρουσιάστηκαν ως κάτι το τελείως αναπάντεχο. Σήμερα όμως είναι γνωστό ότι τουλάχιστον 11 χώρες είχαν προειδοποιήσει την Αμερικανική κυβέρνηση ότι θα γίνει η επίθεση.
The Germans, the French, the Egyptians, the Moroccans, the Jordanians, the Israelis, and the Russians, especially the Russians. Putin appeared on American TV and said, I ordered, George Bush warned in the strongest possible terms.
Η κατάθεση της Κοντολίζα Ράι στην Επιτροπή προκάλεσε μεγάλες αντιδράσεις. Η Σύμβουλος Εθνικής Ασφαλείας παραδέχθηκε ότι υπήρχαν προειδοποιήσεις και πληροφορίες. Στην αρχή ισχυρίστηκε ότι μιλούσαν πράγματι για επιθέσεις της Αλ-Κάιντα, αλλά όχι σε αμερικανικό έδαφος.
The threat reporting that we received in the spring and summer of 2001 was not specific as to time, nor place, nor manner of attack. Almost all of the reports focused on Al-Qaeda activities outside the United States, especially in the Middle East and in North Africa.
Η Σιμπέλ Έντμοντς δεν είχε καθόλου τις ίδιες πληροφορίες. Η Έντμοντς είναι Αμερικανίδα, τουρκικής καταγωγής. Μιλάει τουρκικά, αζέρι και φαρσί. Προσελήφθη στο FBI αμέσως μετά την 11η του Σεπτέμβρη και άρχισε να μεταφράζει συνδιαλέξεις και ντοκουμέντα που είχαν υποκλαπεί πριν την τρομοκρατική επίθεση. Δεν άρχισε να διαπιστώσει ότι η επίθεση θα μπορούσε να είχε αποτραπεί. Σε ένα γράμμα της προς τον πρόεδρο της Επιτροπής διευκρίνιζε τις πληροφορίες που είχε το FBI. Πρώτον, ο Οσάμα Μπιν Λάντεν σχεδίαζε επιθέσεις εναντίον 4-5 πόλεων των Ηνωμένων Πολιτειών. Δεύτερον, οι επιθέσεις θα συμπεριελάμβαναν αεροπλάνα. Τρίτο, ορισμένοι από τους υποψήφιους δράστες βρίσκονταν ήδη μέσα στις Ηνωμένες Πολιτείες. Τέταρτον, οι επιθέσεις θα γίνονταν τους επόμενους μήνες.
We had information in April 2001 that people involved in carrying out the attack will be here. They are here, and the attacks will be carried within the few months, and FBI received this information by end of April.
Η Έντμοντς απευθύνθηκε στους ανωτέρους της στο FBI, ζητώντας να μάθει γιατί οι πληροφορίες δεν είχαν αξιοποιηθεί. Της είπαν να βουλώσει το στόμα της.
Initially, they asked me to not to mention this, not to report it higher up, and they said, well, if you insist that we investigate this thing, it will turn around and become an investigation about you because we don't want to investigate this thing. And they did investigate me. They came to my home and took out my computer. And as part of this unwritten investigation, they asked me to take a polygraph exam. And they said I had three options. Option one, I would refuse to take it and I would be fired. Option two, I would take it and fail and they would fire me. And option three, I would take it and I would pass it, then they would see about that. I took the polygraph test. I passed the polygraph test 100%, and they still fired me at the end of, on March 22nd, 2002.
Η Edmunds δεν είχε ανακαλύψει μόνο ότι το FBI ήξερε από τον Απρίλιο του 2001 το σχέδιο της Al-Qaeda. Οι υποκλοπές του FBI απεδείκνυαν ότι τους τρομοκράτες χρηματοδοτούσαν οργανισμοί μέσα στις ΗΠΑ που σχετίζονταν με διακίνηση ναρκωτικών και ξέπλυμα βρώμικου χρήματος. Βρήκε ακόμη έγγραφα σύμφωνα με τα οποία άνθρωποι μέσα από το FBI συνεργάζονταν με τους οργανισμούς που χρηματοδοτούσαν τους τρομοκράτες. Ήταν αυτοί οι υπάλληλοι του FBI που είχαν εμποδίσει τις μεταφράσεις των κρίσιμων ντοκουμέντων πριν την 11η του Σεπτέμβρη.
Those documents were being blocked from being translated and they were being blocked from being transferred from counterintelligence to counterterrorism because the activities that this information contained were criminal and terrorist-related activities. However, it involved individuals and I call them, refer to them as semi-legit organizations that we consider important. Not we, the people, but certain people consider very sensitive.
You have all sorts of people, and this information that I have provided them, that they have the evidence, it includes many American citizens who were born and raised here, who would be doing things for money.
Οι οργανισμοί που χρηματοδοτούσαν τους τρομοκράτες σχετίζονταν με τις τουρκικές μυστικές υπηρεσίες. Συγχρόνως έδιναν χρήματα και σε Αμερικανούς πολιτικούς. Μετά την άρνηση του FBI να ερευνήσει την υπόθεση, η Edmunds απευθύνθηκε σε δύο γερουσιαστές που βρήκαν τις καταγγελίες της απόλυτα αξιόπιστες. Τις καταγγελίες της Edmunds επιβεβαίωσε και το FBI. Σε επιστολές τους προς τον Υπουργό Δικαιοσύνης John Ashcroft, οι δύο γερουσιαστές ζητούσαν να μάθουν γιατί δεν προχωράει η έρευνα. Η απάντηση του Υπουργού ήταν πρωτοφανής.
Let the eagle soar like she's never soared before.
Attorney General Ashcroft in October 2002 came out and invoked this very rarely invoked privilege called state secret privilege, saying that divulging anything about my case would jeopardize the United States national security at the highest level. Therefore, he stopped the court procedures in my case.
Από εκείνη τη στιγμή, όλα τα στοιχεία, ακόμα και τα γράμματα των δύο γερουσιαστών που είχαν ήδη δημοσιευθεί, θεωρούνται κρατικά απόρριτα. Στην ίδια την Edmunds, τα δικαστήρια έχουν απαγορεύσει στις συνεντεύξεις και τις δηλώσεις της, ακόμα και να χρησιμοποιεί τη λέξη Τουρκία.
Out of 40 questions, I could only answer two. What's my name, where I live here? That was it. I couldn't even say I speak Turkish. Turkish is considered top secret now.
Αμερικανοί αξιωματούχοι, όπως η Κοντολίζα Ράις, υποστήριξαν στην αρχή ότι δεν μπορούσαν να φανταστούν ότι οι αεροπλάνα θα χρησιμοποιούνταν για να χτυπήσουν κτίρια. Εμείς βρήκαμε τις φωτογραφίες που δείχνουν ότι το Πεντάγωνο είχε προετοιμαστεί, είχαν γίνει οι ασκήσεις στην περίπτωση ενός τέτοιου περιστατικού, μιας τέτοιας επίθεσης με αεροπλάνο. Η άσκηση έγινε στο Πεντάγωνο το 2000, ένα χρόνο πριν την επίθεση. Ο Τζον Τζαζ ερευνά την υπόθεση για λογαριασμό μιας κίνησης πολιτών.
Not only did they have sufficient warnings about this type of attack, they prepared for this type of attack. There was an exercise at the Pentagon in October of 2000, simulating a plane crashing into the building. And yet after 9/11, they said, official Pentagon spokesman said, we had no mechanism.
Παρόμοιες πληροφορίες είχε και η επίσημη επιτροπή για την 11η του Σεπτέμβρη.
We have public reports that are listed in the joint inquiry going back into the early 1990s, late 1980s, talking internationally about the different instances of terrorists either planning to use planes as weapons, hijacking a plane and maybe crashing it somewhere. Terrorists attacked the World Trade Center in 1993. They came back in 2001 and hit the same building again. So you have a repetition of the same site, and you have these half a dozen instances, a dozen instances, depending upon what source you're quoting, public sources that have said that terrorists were contemplating planes as weapons.
Υπάρχουν και άλλα γεγονότα που δείχνουν ότι η επίθεση με αεροπλάνα θεωρείται υπαρκτός κίνδυνος. Στη διάσκεψη των 8 πλουσιότερων κρατών που έγινε στη Γένοβα το καλοκαίρι του 2001, είχαν ληφθεί μέτρα εναντίον πιθανής τρομοκρατικής επίθεσης με αεροπλάνο.
At the G8 summit in July of 2001 out in Genoa, they had missile batteries all around Christopher Columbus Airport because they were afraid of a plane coming in and attacking them.
I don't think anybody could have predicted that these people would take an airplane and slam it into the World Trade Center, take another one and slam it into the Pentagon, that they would try to use an airplane as a missile, a hijacked airplane as a missile.
Όταν η Σιμπέλ Έντμοντς άκουσε τις δηλώσεις της Κοντολίζα Ράις, αποφάσισε να παρέμβει δημοσίως.
And the next day I gave a little press conference and I said she's lying. It's an outrageous lie because she said we include she and her FBI counsel and CIA counsel, and I know and FBI knows and FBI has already confirmed of the specific information we had before 9/11 saying that airplanes will be used. 4 to 5 major cities in the United States will be targeted. Therefore, she's lying. During the commission hearing, she came and she changed. She said, I want to apologize and change my statement. I should have said, I didn't know personally, rather than saying we.
I probably should have said, I could have not imagined, because within 2 days, people started to come to me and say, oh, but there were these reports in 1998 and 1999. The intelligence community did look at information about this.
There was huge amount of information. Enough information to at least in June, July 2001 to come out and say, we are putting you in high alert system. We want to raise the security level in the airports.
Η Κοντολίζα Ράις αναγκάστηκε τελικά να παραδεχθεί ότι οι πληροφορίες ήταν πιο συγκεκριμένες. Κατέθεσε όμως ότι το καλοκαίρι του 2001 τόσο το FBI όσο και η Υπηρεσία Πολιτικής Αεροπορίας διατάχθηκαν να πάρουν έκτακτα μέτρα.
The FBI tasked all 56 of its US field offices to increase surveillance of known suspect terrorists and to reach out to known informants who might have information on terrorist activities.
Όμως το FBI κάθε άλλο παρά επαγρυπνούσε. Σε μερικές περιπτώσεις βρέθηκε δίπλα στους αεροπειρατές, αλλά τους αγνόησε.
I learned, for instance, that two of the hijackers on Lisa's plane were known to the CIA. In fact, the CIA even knew that they had attended a terrorism conference in Kuala Lumpur. Nevertheless, they were allowed to enter the country, to live here for months, and to board the plane using their own names.
Οι δύο αεροπειρατές ζούσαν στο ίδιο δωμάτιο με έναν πληροφοριοδότη του FBI.
These two individuals were living with an FBI informant in San Diego. And even though they were living there for, you know, some period of time while the FBI agent who was running that informant was in contact with the informant, they never showed any interest in these two individuals.
Does that all make sense to you?
No, it doesn't.
Your show isn't long enough to explain the number of mistakes that the FBI has made. It is going down a list that seems endless at times.
5 εβδομάδες πριν την 11η του Σεπτέμβρη, το FBI συνέλαβε έναν από τους υποψήφιους αεροπειρατές. Την υπόθεση παρακολουθούσε η πράκτορας του FBI, Colin Rowley.
The summer of 2001, I was the legal counsel for our Minneapolis FBI office, and had been in that position for 11 years. And my peripheral role in the events leading up to 9/11 was that I knew the agents in our office who were investigating one of the people who now later has been charged with the 9/11 attacks, Zacharias Moussaoui.
Ο Ζακαρίας Μασάουι θεωρείται επισήμως ο 20ός αεροπειρατής. δεν πήρε μέρος στο σχέδιο γιατί τον Αύγουστο του 2001 συνελήφθη από το FBI για ύποπτη συμπεριφορά. Ήταν σε μια σχολή πιλότων και ήθελε να μάθει μόνο να πετάει, όχι να προσγειώνεται. Η Ράουλη και ορισμένοι συνάδελφοί της ζήτησαν δικαστική άδεια για να ερευνήσουν τον υπολογιστή του Μασάουι. Αλλά οι ανώτεροι τους απέριψαν το αίτημα. Μετά την 11η του Σεπτέμβρη έγραψε ένα γράμμα προς τον διευθυντή του FBI.
I was quite, you know, nervous about the whole thing. Actually, I can say I didn't sleep a couple of nights when I was doing this, and I was very nervous about the whole thing. And when I finally delivered those envelopes, I mean, my knees were shaking.
Το γράμμα διέρευσε και οι αποκαλύψεις της Ράουλη προκάλεσαν πάταγο. Το περιοδικό Time την ανακήρυξε πρόσωπο της χρονιάς για το 2002 και η πράκτορας του FBI κλήθηκε να καταθέσει στο Κογκρέσο.
I do know that prior to September 11th, a number of classified documents, and probably almost all classified documents, were blocked.
Σήμερα απαγορεύεται να μιλήσει για την ίδια υπόθεση που είναι παγκοσμίως γνωστή.
Do you tell us exactly what happened with Zacharias Massawi before the...
You know, that's kind of a problem, even though this whole letter is out there and it's been widely publicized, it's under a court order because that case is still ongoing for a lot of reasons. I can talk about the endemic issues, but the facts of that case. Now, a lot of the facts of the case are actually in the 9/11 Commission report, some of the facts. But the court, the judge in that case issued a very blanket court order. So we're not supposed to talk about it.
Σεπτέμβριος του 2004, Νέα Υόρκη. Βρισκόμαστε στο Παγκόσμιο Κέντρο Εμπορίου, στον τόπο όπου πριν από 3 χρόνια έγινε η μεγαλύτερη τρομοκρατική επίθεση στην ιστορία των Ηνωμένων Πολιτειών. Βρεθήκαμε εδώ για να ερευνήσουμε πώς και γιατί η μισή περίπου από τους κατοίκους της πόλης, της Νέας Υόρκης, πιστεύουν ότι η Αμερικανική κυβέρνηση ήξερε από πριν ότι θα γίνουν τρομοκρατικές επιθέσεις, αλλά δεν έκανε τίποτα για να τις αποτρέψει. Η συνέχεια αμέσως μετά το διάλειμμα.
You just said that the intelligence coming in indicated a big, big, big threat. Something was going to happen very soon and be potentially catastrophic.
Let me read you some of the actual chatter that was picked up in that spring and summer. Unbelievable news coming in weeks, said one. Big event. There will be a very, 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 very big uproar. There will be attacks in the near future. And that was checked out. And steps were taken through FAA circulars to warn of hijackings. The FAA issued at least 5 civil aviation security information circulars to all U.S. airlines and airport security personnel, including specific warnings about the possibility of hijacking.
Στην πραγματικότητα, και παρά τις προειδοποιήσεις για αεροπειρατείες, κανένα μέτρο ασφαλείας δεν είχε ληφθεί στα αμερικανικά αεροδρόμια.
Well, my name is Diane Kleiman. I was a former special agent with U.S. Customs Service. I worked at JFK International Airport, and I saw immediately upon arriving there major security breaches with the airplanes, which I had to report. The breaches included the fact that airline workers could easily place bombs, weapons on planes. Drugs were being smuggled through with the assistance of airport employees.
Στην κοινή συνέντευξη τύπου των πρακτόρων των μυστικών υπηρεσιών, στην τρίτη επέτειο της 11ης του Σεπτέμβρη, η Κλέιμαν ήταν αποκαλυπτική.
These employees and their bags are not subject to daily checks upon arriving at work, such as the case as with corrections officers at prisons. They can carry weapons and bombs to work, and they have easy access to placing these weapons on planes. Many of these employees are illegal aliens and are predicate felons. Some having outstanding warrants for their arrest. When an employee is fired or quits, rarely does he turn over his ramp pass and can gain access, easy access to the planes, simply by swiping his ID card at any of the many unmanned doors leading to the ramps.
So you mean 10 terrorists can put 10 bombs in 10 different planes, like an old project was of Al-Qaeda?
Absolutely. It's so easy and so inexpensive. You can have 10 workers who decide to apply for a job, and they get the jobs the same day as baggage workers on the planes. They have their security passes, so they can come in at 3 o'clock in the morning and place knapsacks with time-detonated bombs on the planes. And when the planes take off later that day, they explode, taking all the passengers down with them. And they're gone before customs or the government could even suspect them. And I think that there would be a hard time even pointing the finger at anybody, because there are so many workers who go in and out of all the airports, particularly JFK.
6 μήνες πριν την 11η Σεπτεμβρίου, η Κλέιμαν είχε κάνει μια σειρά αναφορές για τα προβλήματα ασφαλείας στο αεροδρόμιο της Νέας Υόρκης.
All my evaluations, which were very good, they were all taken away, they were stolen from my desk, and I was told that they were going to redo them and make me look like a bad employee. Family members were threatened, my mother's life was threatened. Started having a lot of problems in my government vehicle. I would have blowouts in my tires and carbon monoxide leaks, things like that. They were sending me a message that I needed to keep my mouth shut and go along with the program.
Στις 6 Αυγούστου του 2001, ενώ έκανε διακοπές στο ράντσο του στο Τέξας, ο Αμερικανός πρόεδρος ενημερώθηκε γραπτός από τη CIA ότι η Αλ-Κάιντα προετοίμαζε επιθέσεις. Για πολλούς μήνες, ο Λευκός Οίκος αρνείται να δημοσιοποιήσει το σχετικό έγγραφο. Στην κατάθεσή της, η Κοντολίτζα Ράις, υπεύθυνη για την ασφάλεια της χώρας και τον συντονισμό των μυστικών υπηρεσιών, επέμενε ότι επρόκειτο για ένα έγγραφο με ανώδυνες πληροφορίες, ιστορικού χαρακτήρα.
It did not warn of attacks inside the United States. It was historical information based on old reporting. There was no new threat information, and it did not, in fact, warn of any coming attacks inside the United States. What the August 6th PDB said, and perhaps I should read it to you.
We would be happy to have it declassified in full at this time, including its title. Isn't it a fact, Dr. Rice, that the August 6th PDB warned against possible attacks in this country? And I ask you whether you recall the title of that PDB.
I believe the title was Bin Laden Determined to Attack Inside the United States. No, Mr. Benveniste, I would like to finish my point here.
Μία εβδομάδα μετά, ο Λευκός Οίκος έδωσε στη δημοσιότητα την πρώτη μια μισή σελίδα από τις 11 σελίδες του εγγράφου με την ενημέρωση του Προέδρου από τη CIA. Ημερομηνία 6 Αυγούστου του 2001. Το έγγραφο δεν προσδιόριζε χρόνο ή τόπο επίθεσης. Έγραφε όμως ότι ο Μπιν Λάντεν σχεδίαζε να χτυπήσει μέσα στις Ηνωμένες Πολιτείες, χρησιμοποιώντας μέλη της Αλ-Κάιντα, μερικά από τα οποία είναι Αμερικανοί πολίτες. Προσέθεται ακόμη ότι οι πληροφορίες του FBI μιλούσαν για ύποπτες δραστηριότητες σχετιζόμενες με αεροπειρατείες. Ήταν 6 εβδομάδες πριν την 11η του Σεπτέμβρη.
Well, Bush still takes long vacations. He usually takes the whole month of August. He's like a European. You know, he takes long, long August vacations. You know, the joke we have in America is we just wish he'd give the rest of us that long a vacation. You know, nobody else gets to take that amount of time off. The president is always going down to Texas to fix up the fence at his ranch. And
I love the nature. I love to get in the pickup truck with my dogs.
Oh, hi.
So I went out there the other day, and there was Barney buried in his hole, chasing an armadillo.
Την 11η του Σεπτέμβρη, ο πρόεδρος Μπους βρισκόταν σε περιοδεία στη Φλόριδα. Μετά το πρωινό τζόκινγκ, σχεδίαζε να επισκεφθεί ένα σχολείο. Γύρω στις 8 και 15 το πρωί, ο πύργος ελέγχου του αεροδρομίου της Βοστόνης διαπίστωσε ότι η πρώτη πτήση, αριθμός 11, άλλαξε πορεία. Πιθανώς είχε γίνει αεροπειρατεία. Στις 8 και 20, δύο αεροσυνοδοί ειδοποίησαν για την αεροπειρατεία. Στις 8 και 24 λεπτά, οι αεροπειρατές μίλησαν στους επιβάτες.
We have some planes that stay quiet and will be okay. We are turning to the airport. Nobody moves. Everything will be okay. If you try to make any move, you danger yourself and the
Στις 8:30 ο Αμερικανός πρόεδρος μπήκε στο αυτοκίνητό του για να πάει στο σχολείο. Την ίδια ώρα, ο πύργος ελέγχου στη Βοστόνη διαπίστωνε ότι και ένα δεύτερο αεροπλάνο είχε αλλάξει πορεία. Στη διάρκεια της πορείας προς το σχολείο σημειώθηκε η τρίτη αεροπειρατεία. Φτάνοντας στο σχολείο, ο Αμερικανός πρόεδρος θα πρέπει να είχε ειδοποιηθεί ήδη για τις αεροπειρατείες.
The chain of command operates in such a way that when the first airliner was known to be hijacked, the whole national command system goes into a very strict and rigid set of protocols for how it responds. And that includes notification of the White House.
By 8:40, the NORAD was informed by the FAA that there were two planes that had been hijacked, Flight 175 and Flight 11. And at that point, according to the FAA, a phone bridge was established with all the relevant agencies. So that means the CIA, the FBI, the Situation Room at the Pentagon. So 8:40, they knew two planes had been hijacked. The first plane hit around 8:46. So sometime, only a few minutes later.
Μπαίνοντας στο σχολείο, ο πρόεδρος Μπους πρέπει να ήξερε ότι το αεροπλάνο που είχε πέσει στο δίδυμο πύργο ήταν ένα από αυτά που είχαν πέσει στα χέρια των αεροπειρατών. Παρ' όλα αυτά, δημοσίως έχει δώσει μια τελείως διαφορετική εκδοχή. Υποστηρίζει ότι πριν μπει στην τάξη για να συναντήσει τους μαθητές, είδε στην τηλεόραση το πρώτο αεροπλάνο να πέφτει στον πύργο και νόμισε ότι ήταν ατύχημα.
Foolish soul had gotten lost and made a terrible mistake.
I mean, his own story about the events is absolutely incongruous. It doesn't make sense, not possible. His official story was he was getting ready to begin to start speaking to the children when he saw a newscast of the first plane flying into the World Trade Center, and he said, oh, that's one really bad pilot. Well, in truth, the video of the first plane wasn't available for hours.
I was sitting outside the classroom waiting to go in, and I saw an airplane hit the tower the TV was obviously on, and I used to fly myself, and I said, well, there's one terrible pilot. And I said it must have been a horrible accident.
No, well, yeah, he didn't tell the truth, whatever. The point is, the President Bush's account is when he first entered the school, he was told about the hijacking, and then he saw on a TV screen, apparently a video of the first plane hitting the World Trade Center, and then he went into the classroom. But that was impossible because there was no video of the very first plane hitting the World Trade Center.
Στο βιβλίο του «Πρόσχημα για πόλεμο», ο γνωστός Αμερικανός δημοσιογράφος James Bufford περιγράφει λεπτό προς λεπτό τα γεγονότα εκείνης της ημέρας. Λέει ότι τις πρώτες ώρες είδαμε βίντεο μόνο από το δεύτερο πύργο. Εικόνες από την πρόσκρουση του πρώτου αεροπλάνου βρέθηκαν και άρχισαν να προβάλλονται από τις τηλεοράσεις την επόμενη μέρα, στις 12 Σεπτεμβρίου.
There was video of the second plane. So if he saw the second plane hit the World Trade Center, you ask a question of why did he go into the classroom? You know, those two planes have been attacking the World Trade Center 10 minutes apart.
Στις 9:03 λεπτά χτυπήθηκε ο δεύτερος πύργος. Στις 9:06 ο διευθυντής του Λευκού Οίκου ειδοποίησε τον πρόεδρό του.
I mean, you would have to be beyond stupid to think that two planes would accidentally crash into the World Trade Center on the same day.
America is under attack. Yet for 7 minutes, he just sits there and does nothing. He sits there and continues to read about a goat to a class of second graders. And all the time, he's never asked a single question about what's the status of NORAD? Where's our military defenses? Where's the Secretary of Defense? Let me speak to Condoleezza Rice. He doesn't ask for a single person. He doesn't ask a single question. So it brings into question what was he doing there for 7 minutes while the country was under attack.
Οι υποστηριχτές του Προέδρου Μπούς, όπως ο Λιν Νόφσιγκερ, υποστηρίζουν ότι τίποτα δεν θα άλλαζε.
For 7 minutes, my question is, what would you have had him do in those 7 minutes? Go out and run around and said, hey, they're bombing us? Secondly, Kerry himself has admitted that he sat there for about 40 minutes absolutely paralyzed when he heard what was going on. So he has admitted he would have sat there for 40 minutes, because he did, and Bush sat there for 7 minutes trying not to excite people and probably figuring out, okay, you know, let's see what the situation is. There's nothing he could have done in those 7 minutes.
But he also knew that there were two other planes already hijacked and going around Washington, I don't know where.
No, one out there in Pennsylvania and one getting ready to run into
yes,
the Pentagon.
Yes, I mean, he should have ordered the jets to scramble the...
Well, my question is, what would you have had him do? I mean, it's very easy to criticize him for having sat there for 7 minutes, which is hardly a lifetime, but nobody has said what he should have done in those 7 minutes.
Get ready.
Flying in midair, I thought I was dreaming. When I saw the suitcases, well, briefcases, I said that they were briefcases, but flying in the air, and I saw a chair, I was like, this has got to be a bad dream. This has to be a bad dream.
A lot of things happened in those 7 minutes. Planes were flying at 500 miles an hour. They were attacking numerous locations. There was no idea what the extent of this was. Any logical person immediately would have said, I need more information. Excuse me, class, let me go and I'll be back a little bit later. What's the problem with that? What it looked like was he was frozen. Like he was shocked. He didn't know what to do.
Well, I had just been told by Andrew Card that America was under attack, and I was collecting my thoughts, and I was sitting with a bunch of young kids, and I made the decision there that we would let this part of the program finish, and then I would calmly stand up and thank the teacher and thank the children and go take care of business. And
but his explanation of events is beyond, you know, if you were charitable and wanted to believe President Bush on that, you would still have to fire him, lock him up, and put him on medication.
Λίγες ώρες μετά τις επιθέσεις, οι αρχές έδωσαν στη δημοσιότητα τα ονόματα και τις φωτογραφίες των 19 αεροπειρατών. Όμως τα ονόματα τους λείπουν από τις λίστες των επιβατών που έδωσαν στη δημοσιότητα οι αεροπορικές εταιρείες. Η πραγματική ταυτότητα κάποιων αεροπειρατών ίσως να μην είναι ακόμη γνωστή.
5 or 6 people came forward in Egypt and in Saudi Arabia afterwards and said, that's me, that's my picture, my identification. I wasn't on that plane, I'm still alive, I live here, I wasn't in the United States, which means that they were carrying false ID. But if they were carrying false ID, who are they?
Οι Αμερικανικές αρχές ανακοίνωσαν ότι η επικεφαλής της ομάδας των 19 ήταν ο Μοχάμεντ Άτα. Πώς έγινε γνωστό αυτό αμέσως? Η απάντηση μπορεί να είναι η παρακάτω. Λίγες μέρες πριν τις επιθέσεις, ο Μοχάμεντ Άτα χρηματοδοτήθηκε με 100.000 δολάρια από τον στρατηγό Μαχμούντ Αχμάτ, αρχηγό των Πακιστανικών Μυστικών Υπηρεσιών.
$100,000 was transferred to Mohammed Atta in Sarasota, Florida, in August of 2001, just before the attack. Atta is seen as the ringleader. That $100,000 came through an intermediary, Salid Sheikh. Salid Sheikh got the money directly from the head of Pakistani intelligence, General Muhammad Ahmad. In fact, Ahmad came to the United States in early September. He met with Armitage and Powell at the State Department. He met with George Tenet, his counterpart at the CIA. And on the morning of the attack, he was having breakfast with Porter Goss and Bob Graham, who later did the joint inquiry on 9/11.
Σύμφωνα με τις επίσημες ανακοινώσεις, οι αεροπειρατές είχαν μάθει να πιλοτάρουν σε σχολές. Ορισμένοι δεν είχαν πετάξει ούτε καν με μικρά εκπαιδευτικά αεροπλάνα. Όμως ειδικά το χτύπημα του Πενταγώνου ήταν δύσκολο ακόμη και για έμπειρους πιλότους.
I was told by pilots that the maneuver of Flight 77 over the Pentagon, a descending loop from 5,000 feet, a tight curve, 270 degrees or better, all the way around the Pentagon, and then flying at 400 to 500 knots, low enough to knock off lamp poles, is a very difficult thing to do unless you are an extremely experienced military or civilian pilot.
Από την επίθεση στο Πεντάγωνο, κανένα φιλμ, βίντεο ή φωτογραφία δεν έχει δοθεί στη δημοσιότητα. Τα βίντεο από τις κάμερες του ξενοδοχείου Sheraton, που βρίσκεται δίπλα, έχουν χαρακτηριστεί απόρριτα. Ένα ακόμη ερώτημα είναι γιατί το αεροπλάνο δεν αντιμετωπίστηκε από την αεροπορική άμυνα του Πεντάγωνου.
I grew up in the Pentagon, the son of civilian employees of the Pentagon, and one day when I was about 10 years old in the 1950s, my parents took me outside for lunch, and in the main courtyard I sat on a silver box and my dad told me to get off of it. I asked him what it was. He said it was a surface-to-air missile port.
Το Πεντάγωνο χτυπήθηκε στις 9:38, σχεδόν μία ώρα μετά την πρόσκληση του πρώτου αεροπλάνου στους δίδυμους πύργους. Ένα από τα βασικά ερωτήματα είναι γιατί δεν αναχαιτίστηκε από την πολεμική αεροπορία.
Each commercial jet that flies in the air over this country has a flight plan. As soon as they deviate from that flight plan, there are procedures in place that require the FAA to immediately notify NORAD, and then NORAD responds by scrambling one of their jets, which are on strip alert, which means they can get in the air from anywhere from, you know, 6 to 12 minutes. They can be in the air and travel at, you know, 2-3 times the speed of sound and engage and investigate.
Στο διάστημα ανάμεσα στον Ιούνιο του 2000 και τον Σεπτέμβριο του 2001, πολεμικά αεροπλάνα είχαν αναχαιτήσει 67 πτήσεις πολιτικών αεροπλάνων, διασήμαντο αφορμή. Με τις 4 πτήσεις που έπεσαν θύματα αεροπειρατείας, αυτή η διαδικασία δεν τηρήθηκε.
The FAA says they informed NORAD immediately of the hijacked planes. NORAD is saying they were not informed till much later, you know, like a half an hour later.
Την 11η Σεπτέμβρη το πρωί βρισκόταν σε εξέλιξη η τακτική εξαμηνιαία άσκηση για την αεράμινα, την άμυνα της χώρας απέναντι σε αεροπορικές επιθέσεις. Είχε την κωδική ονομασία Vigilant Guardian, άγρυπνος φρουρός.
There was an exercise across the country to prepare in case of an invasion of all things, an air invasion. But they were thinking more that it would be somebody like the Russians or a drug dealer or somebody who would send a plane across the borders. So they were preparing for a exercise, but the exercise was looking outside the borders and not inside the borders.
Why were they scrambled from Langley, which is CIA headquarters, over 120, 130 miles away, instead of Andrews, which is only 12 miles away?
Well, the problem was that NORAD had planned for years and years that if we were attacked, it was going to be Russian bombers coming over the North Pole or else going into the East or West Coast. So all the radar was looking out, And after the Cold War, the threat from Russia and all these other places reduced a great deal. So at the time of the attacks on September 11th, there were only 14 aircraft at 7 different bases all around the country. So you only had 14 fighter jets protecting the entire United States. And none of those fighter jets were anywhere near the two major cities, Washington, D.C. and New York.
And what really kind of bugs me more than anything, there was a professional golfer, Payne Stewart, who, before September 11th ever happened, got on a small chartered commercial jet and took off towards Chicago. And the plane suffered explosive decompression, a window blew out or something, and everybody died on the plane. But because the plane was on autopilot, it continued to fly. 21 minutes, it took 21 minutes for the air traffic controllers to get an F-16 fighter to come in behind and do a visual inspection and see what was going on. On September 11th, there were 4 commercial aircraft filled with hundreds of people on every radar screen in the Eastern Seaboard with their transponders off, not responding to anything for 2 full hours. And not until everything was over did any fighter aircraft take to the air. I would love for somebody to explain to me how that can happen.
Αντίθετα με τον Bill Clinton που κατέθεσε στην Επιτροπή επί 4 ώρες, ο πρόεδρος Bush δεν ήθελε να καταθέσει επισήμως. Στην αρχή πρόκρινε μια επίσκεψη εθιμοτυπίας.
Will you testify before the commission?
This commission? You know, I don't testify. I mean, I'd be glad to visit with them.
Μετά τις πιέσεις από τους συγγενείς των θυμάτων, δέχτηκε να μιλήσει στην Επιτροπή, με τον όρο ότι δεν θα ορκίζονταν όπως οι άλλοι που κατέθεσαν.
If we had something to hide, we wouldn't have met with them in the first place. We answered all their questions, and as I say, I think I came away good about the session because I wanted them to know, you know, how I set strategy, how we run the White House, how we deal with threats.
Ο πρόεδρος και αντιπρόεδρος δεν δέχτηκαν να συνομιλήσουν ξεχωριστά με τα μέλη της Επιτροπής. Απάντησαν στις ερωτήσεις και οι δύο μαζί. Γεγονός που εξόργησε τους επικριτές τους.
The important thing about 9/11 commission is it's not really the work of an independent commission. It's an independent commission by name. An independent commission would not have allowed the President of the United States to come to the commission with his own nanny, the Vice President of the United States, so that they were debriefed together.
I actually believe that President Bush was not able to answer certain questions about 9/11 and its aftermath because he has been a very hands-off leader and he needed Dick Cheney to sit at his side because Cheney knew the answers. Notably, while the president was down in Florida reading books to children on 9/11, Cheney was in the White House running things. I find it absurd that they had this joint testimony. I think it was totally inappropriate. I think that the commission should have rejected it. Unfortunately, the commission was so desperate to get the two of them to testify that they felt this is the only way to do it, so they accepted it. Some reporters did ask that in a press conference, and President Bush gave them a silly answer.
The vice president answered a lot of their questions, answered all their questions, and I think it was important for them to see our body language as well, how we work together. But it was, you know, the commissioners will speak for themselves over time. They will let you know whether they thought it was a fruitful series of discussions. I think they found it to be useful.
Το περιεχόμενο της άτυπης συνομιλίας δεν έγινε γνωστό. Τα μέλη της Επιτροπής που τον επισκέφθηκαν στο Λευκό Οίκο δεν είχαν δικαίωμα να κρατούν σημειώσεις. Τα πρακτικά της συνομιλίας είναι απόρριτα. Μετά από πιέσεις των συγγενών των θυμάτων, στην Επιτροπή κατέθεσε και η Σιμπέλ Έντμοντς. Η κατάθεσή της έγινε κάτω από αυστηρά μέτρα ασφαλείας και είναι απόρριτη.
Because of all the gag orders and because of top secret security implications, it had to be behind closed doors.
And you were in a very special room, which is I read somewhere.
SCIF. It's called SCIF, S-C-I-F. It's a secured compartmentalized intelligence facility or something. This is the room you go. Nobody can bug this room. It's like a safe. You go inside a safe.
Το τελικό πόρισμα της Επιτροπής δεν αναφέρεται καθόλου στις πληροφορίες της Edmonds.
There is no report of the commission. This was just like some kind of a maybe political, semi-fiction, loosely based on a true story kind of a report. Look, there is no accountability mentioned there. It says, and think about it, they came up with this novel fiction that everybody is happy with. Republicans and Democrats and senators and congressmen and the agencies. So how could you come up with a report that everybody is happy? You have to have nothing in it, and they did that very nicely.
Η Σιμπέλ Έντμοντς συνεχίζει να αντιμετωπίζει προβλήματα λόγω της αιμονής της να αποκαλυφθεί η αλήθεια. Οι υπάλληλοι του FBI, τους οποίους κατηγόρησε ότι συνειδητά δεν μετέφρασαν τις προειδοποιήσεις και είχαν επαφές με τους τρομοκράτες, απείλησαν τη ζωή της. Οι τουρκικές μυστικές υπηρεσίες ανέκριναν την αδελφή της στη Κωνσταντινούπολη. Δεν μπορεί να πει ούτε σε ποια χώρα αναφέρεται.
My sister lived in another country where I came from. And after I came across the documentation and the evidence, and I was threatened by this individual that my family's life would be placed in danger. Well, sure enough, about a month later, my sister in another country, in her house, she was served by a subpoena to come for an interrogation.
Παρότι έχει καταθέσει δημοσίως στη Γερουσία, η Colin Rowley δεν επιτρέπεται σήμερα να μιλήσει για την υπόθεση του 20ου αεροπειρατή. Μιλώντας στο ρεπορτάζ χωρίς σύνορα, η πράκτορας του FBI μπορεί να χάσει τη σύνταξή της που παίρνει το Δεκέμβρη.
Of course, until the time that you're eligible, and it's happened on a few occasions, if somebody messes up, you can be fired and then you lose your pension. That's correct. And, you know, some of this stuff I'm doing in speaking out, I do follow the FBI's rules. I'm careful to go through our pre-publication review.
In a way, the investigation on 11 September was lost in translation.
No. Yes, it has been lost in translation and also interpretation and also maybe analysis. So it's a lost cause.
Όλα τα αρχεία της υπόθεσης έχουν χαρακτηριστεί απόρριτα. Θα δοθούν στη δημοσιότητα στις 2 Ιανουαρίου του 2009.
What was this date, January 2nd of 2009? What significance did it have? And I realized that even if Bush goes back in, it's one day beyond when he can possibly be in office.
Στο επόμενο επεισόδιο, ο James Bufford έφερε στη δημοσιότητα τα συγκλονιστικά ντοκουμέντα της μυστικής επιχείρησης Northwoods. Το 1962, για να προκαλέσει εισβολή στην Κούβα, το Αμερικανικό Πεντάγωνο σχεδίαζε μια σειρά τρομοκρατικές επιθέσεις μέσα στις Ηνωμένες Πολιτείες, καθώς και κατάρριψη αμερικανικού αεροπλάνου. Για τις επιθέσεις αυτές θα κατηγορούσαν τις κουβανικές μυστικές υπηρεσίες.
In order to justify going into Cuba, the Joint Chiefs of Staff came up with this plan called Operation Northwoods, and that involved very secretly creating scenarios in the United States where people would be shot on streets, buildings would be blown up. They had plans where they were going to have a plane look like it was being shot down, a plane full of passengers look like it was going to be shot down by the Cubans.
Το σχέδιο εγκρίθηκε από το Γενικό Επιτελείο και τον επικεφαλής του, στρατηγό Λίμαν Λέμτσερ, που αργότερα έγινε ανώτατος διοικητής του ΝΑΤΟ. Αλλά απορρίφθηκε από τον πρόεδρο Κένεντι και τον τότε υπουργό Αμήνης Μακναμάρα. Το 2000, λίγο πριν τις προεδρικές εκλογές, η ομάδα των αποκαλούμενων νεοσυντηρητικών έδωσε στη δημοσιότητα το σχέδιο για τον νέο Αμερικανικό αιώνα. Προέβλεπε επίθεση στο Ιράκ και προληπτικούς πολέμους. Ριζική αναθεώρηση της αμερικανικής εξωτερικής πολιτικής. Οι συντάκτες του τόνιζαν ότι το σχέδιο ήταν αδύνατο να υιοθετηθεί από την αμερικανική κοινή γνώμη, εκτός και μεσολαβούσε μια καταστροφική επίθεση εναντίον των Ηνωμένων Πολιτειών. Ένα νέο Pearl Harbor. Ένα χρόνο μετά, ήρθε η 11η Σεπτεμβρίου. Επικεφαλής της ομάδας των εσωτερικών είναι ο αντιπρόεδρος των Ηνωμένων Πολιτειών Dick Cheney, ο υπουργός αμήνης Donald Rumsfeld και ο υφυπουργός του Paul Wolfowitz. Αντίστοιχες προτάσεις είχαν υποβάλει και το 1992. Οι πράκτορες της CIA είχαν τότε μια περίεργη ονομασία για την ομάδα αυτή.
As we looked at the folks who were running this policy, it became clear to us that these were the same folks that we used to call the crazies. I would look for the possibility of a terrorist event, whether it's real or it's contrived.
Νέες αποκαλύψεις για το πώς η 11η Σεπτέμβρη χρησιμοποιήθηκε για την εισβολή στο Ιράκ.
It was clear that Iraq was at the very top of the agenda from the very first day of the administration. It wasn't after 9/11 or a reaction to it. It was from the first National Security Council meeting, January the 30th, 2001.
Η 11η Σεπτέμβρη, ο Λευκός Οίκος και η Σαουδική Αραβία. Τι είπε η αδελφή του Μπιν Λάδεν όταν στις 13 Σεπτεμβρίου του 2001 την φυγάδευσαν από τις Ηνωμένες Πολιτείες.
So this young sister of Bin Laden was on the plane, and as they landed in Orlando, she sort of burst into tears. And one of the flight attendants went over to comfort her and said, listen, really, you shouldn't be crying. Don't worry, it's not your fault. And the young woman said, yeah, but he is my brother.